Hey, and welcome back to another devlog episode of the game I'm currently working on named Catch Me. It is a simple top-down game about making enemies collide to kill them. The last update of the game was 2 months ago, so a lot of things have changed and the game is finally getting closer and closer to being finished. And also thank you a lot for 200 subscribers and your continuous support. So with that, let's get into it. First up, I added some essential and important features, like for example the credits and a tutorial. Especially the tutorial is pretty important because it's way easier to enjoy a game if you understand it than if you have no idea of how to play it. I don't think for such a simple game it's too necessary, but it's better to have one regardless. I wanted to work on it a while ago, but I didn't have any good structure that would explain the game in a simple way. But while searching for any inspiration, I came across a simple and easy way to construct the tutorial. The first step is to write down everything the player should know and then go through each one and decide if the player can figure it out by himself or if you should explain it in a tutorial. This makes creating a tutorial way easier because you exactly know what you want to do. So with the concept in place, it was quite easy to code as well. Maybe I will clean it up a bit more and make it more fun to go through, but the tutorial is finished for now. In the last few weeks, I've been testing out new concepts and ideas for how levels in particular work. One concept I thought about was a wave-based spawning system for the enemies. In every level, there are a specific amount of waves. In each wave, a few amount of different enemy types spawn, with a specific spawn rate. The waves only last for a certain time, and as soon as one ends, the next one starts. There's no downtime between them, so the player won't get out of the flow state. That's exactly what I worked on for the next 2 days. For me, the system makes way more sense because there's no point on getting points through killing enemies, which actually spawn in regular intervals. So with both systems, you will spend nearly the same time in one level. It just makes pretty much no difference. But I just think that the wave system is way clearer and simpler. And it also makes levels more different and unique. I experimented a bit with level design elements as well. I tried to come up with some way of making levels interesting and unique. Something that makes all levels different from one another, except the enemies and the waves in every level. Maybe you have any idea for a level element which would make it more interesting for players to play each level. There are very not that many games which have a similar gameplay or level structure, so if you have any idea or tip, please write it down in the comments. Some months ago, I made a video showing some methods for improving the feel of nearly every game. While looking back to it, I noticed that the experimental game I made for the video actually feels and looks so much more alive and juicy than Catch Me. I quickly realized how to change that. First of all, I added some post-processing effects when enemies die to make it feel more satisfying. I already used this method in Jump Now, a game I made for the GMTK Game Jam in 48 hours. I also changed the sounds for some death effects of some enemies and made the effects more satisfying. And overall, the game needed some more feedback for the player. For example, the shooter enemy now has an animation before shooting, so the player knows when it's going to shoot. It just doesn't feel that unpredictable anymore. Last but not least, I started working on the credits at the end of the game. They aren't finished and still need some more polish. I will also have to work more on these transitions after killing a boss because they look pretty lame right now. But I shouldn't take too much time working on these little details because I want to release the game in 2020. And before I can release it, I should actually focus on finishing the game sometime soon so you guys can playtest it. But that's it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed watching and if you did, please leave a like. I would also really like to see your feedback in the comments down below. And with that, see you next time.